We all love the dog days of summer, but what about our furry friends? They like being outside, but our pets can actually have the same heat-related problems that affect all of us. So joining us this morning to help us out to make sure they are safe from West Loop Veterinary Care is Dr. David Gonsky. Thanks so much for coming
You're welcome today.
Tell us what you have here.
This is Spencer.
Look,
Spencer, hey, bud. Spencer's a Tibetan Terrier.
Oh, Spencer is absolutely gorgeous. Okay,
yeah.
And I look at Spencer, and Spencer has a beautiful coat. My first thought is, how do dogs like Spencer do in this heat?
You know, dogs can do okay, but we have to be very careful in the heat, Sylvia. Spencer's got a long coat, but this coat helps actually protect him a little bit from the sun. So a lot of people in the summer think, oh,
yeah,
I'll shave my dog
right
down. That'll keep him cool. Keep it over an inch long because it'll protect him from the sun.
Okay, so you don't want to completely shave them because that's a bad thing. Oh, I didn't think about that.
Yeah.
Okay.
And so what we have to be cautious of is heat stroke. Dogs in the summer, just like people, can get overheated. So
aww,
it's okay, Spencer. It's okay,
Spencer,
bud.
Spencer's sad. Spencer wants to go to mommy who's out there.
So when we're taking our dogs out in the heat, let's take them out in the morning for a short walk, in the evening for a short walk. Keep them out of that hot sun of the day. And if a dog like Spencer, it's okay, bud.
I don't think
if he was lagging behind me on the walk, if he was panting a lot,
right,
if he was starting to slow down, I might be concerned he was overheating and get him home.
Yeah.
If you're out on a walk with your dog and their gums are turning bright red, the saliva is getting real thick and ropey, cool them down and consider getting to the vet if they may be overheating.
Oh, wow, okay. And so what's the best way to cool them down immediately besides trying to get water and...
Just water, cool water into their mouth, and then also maybe some damp rags, wet their feet, but
really,
get to the vet.
Feet. Okay.
Get to the vet. They're really stressed out, and they're really thick, ropey saliva and red gums, and they look anxious.
Yeah.
Get to the vet.
That's
okay,
not a good sign, right?
Come
here,
come on my lap.
So,
come here, you.
So, Spencer's just gorgeous, and if Spencer decides that he wants to leave, he is allowed, just so you know. So, when is a good time to take our dogs out for exercise? Because, you know, I like the last few days, this week actually, has been so hot. I've been afraid. It's 8 o'clock at night, and it's 90 degrees, you know?
Yeah.
So when's the best time to do that?
So the best times are morning and night. I always tell my clients, go out early, go out late, and go out for a short period of time. I joke, poop, pee, back inside.
get the job done and get back in the house.
And extra caution, if there are a lot of clients who have brachycephalic dogs, like bulldogs, French bulldogs, pugs, very careful with those in the heat. They have a hard time cooling off.
Okay, so be careful about that. So how much water should we be giving our dogs when they're outside?
As much as they need.
Yeah, just bring the bowl with you if you're out, right?
Bring, or, you know, now they have all kinds of things you can use.
Hey, Spencer, it's okay. And the other thing I wanted to ask you about, Doctor, is we are expecting
Spencer,
some possible major thunderstorms this evening. And my dog has all of a sudden developed this fear of thunder. What can we do to help them? Because he pants and breathes so hard.
Oh.
I say let Spencer go.
Let him go.
Run.
Go
free
on, Spencer.
Free Spencer. Hashtag free Spencer, everybody. Much happier now he's with his mom.
Yeah, poor guy.
So what do you do, you know, because I've heard of different things like thunder shirts. I even put a T-shirt on him once. My daughter didn't tie it tightly. What can we do?
Okay. So not only thunderstorms, but also 4th of July is coming up.
That's the
fireworks.
Other thing, yes.
So there are a lot of dogs scared about that. The best thing I can tell you is to talk to your veterinarian because it's a combination of things. We have some thunder shirts can be helpful. Sometimes just a dark enclosed environment like a closet or a bathroom will work. But sometimes medications are needed.
Really? Okay.
And we have some great medications.
That's interesting because I've noticed he runs to the basement, which is darker because the lights are usually, and he always runs to the basement.
And that's okay. Don't force him out of there. If he likes to be in the basement and that's his safe place, and there's less windows and let him stay down there. It's okay.
Okay, but then how do you know when you should think about medication? Because you really don't want to medicate if you don't have to, but you know, how can you tell if the anxiety is too much?
When the basement's not helping, the thunder shirt's not helping, and your pet is beside themselves in that situation.
Okay. Yeah. Good advice. Good advice. Thanks so much for coming in. Can we get one last Spencer on the couch here? But we do appreciate your advice. And you can sit with Spencer. That was the thing. Mama should have been here. Thanks so much. I'm so glad to have you here. I love your bedside manner. Very, very nice.
Thank you.
We have to talk afterwards.